Yo, what up, Stud Muffins? Welcome back, and today we got a lot of news. We have a lot of good news, actually. Like, we got Activision making money and talking about making money, so, you know, we're gonna be talking about that. We got Black Ops 5, Modern Warfare, GTA 6, PlayStation 5. We have a lot of really good news, and I'm pretty sure that these updates will get you hyped. I'm personally shocked by the fact that people got along, but at the same time, I do want to give you a little bit of a nug here. You may be disappointed, okay? You may be triggered, but I don't think you should be, because overall, I think the information is good, and let's just get right into it. If you love your mama, smash that like button. And first of all, I'm gonna talk about PS5, because yes, like, its logo was revealed, and they were saying that we're gonna show you the new logo, but apparently it was not the new logo, it was the same logo. But to me, I honestly am not even worried about it. Like, I'm glad that it looks the same, because obviously logos and stuff like that, I really don't care. The hardware matters, right? The console looks matters. In fact, to me, I don't even give a damn about the console look. If it looks like a potato, but it runs like butter, I would take the buttery part, because I love butter, right? I've actually learned this from Activision, because they like to butter people up with their marketing strats and feel like that. So I honestly don't care. But this is the logo. It's simple, it's effective, something that we're familiar with. And they also revealed the PlayStation 5 hardware features, and a lot of it was actually leaked, and obviously now all of it came true. And this is coming from Comic Book, and they say that Respawn First makes the claim that the first PS4, or I mean the PlayStation 4 controller, the DualShock 4, will be fully compatible with the next-gen PlayStation console. This is not only excellent news for the fans of the controller, but is a good sign that we could get full backwards compatibility with the PS4, and that was something that was already confirmed. But you wanna know what? This is a little bit shocking, and I really hope that this one is good. But before I tell you guys the news, just pump the brakes. Like, do not let your dogs, like, keep your dogs in, because this is coming from Hip Hop Gamer, and word on the street is that this guy is manly. I mean, the guy looks manly. He has been credible in the past, is what I'm hearing. But at the same time, man, these are just rumors. These are just leaks, okay? I believe the leaks. I love the leaks. But when I'm reporting the news, I want to make sure that I'm reporting you the way I hear it, and not, like, add extra sauce in it. I love actually saucing stuff, but I'm just going to let you know that. Do not let your dogs out. But he says that PlayStation 5 will also have remastering engine for PS1, PS2, PS3, and PS4 titles, and it will also have backwards compatibility, but this time it will come with an enhanced feature. And this is interesting, because obviously what this means is that not only that PlayStation 5 will be able to play like the PS4 games, but PS3, PS2, and PS1, and on top it's gonna have that backwards compatibility enhanced feature, where if you actually remember playing GTA San Andreas, I believe it was like running at 480p. I'm not totally sure what the resolution was, but let's say 480p, right? But now on PS5 it can go up to 8k, because PlayStation 5 will support 8K upscaling. So this is pretty good news. I mean, I don't see it having like better textures, but it's definitely gonna have like better performance, better FPS. And honestly, man, I'm really hoping that this is true. Sony, you sons of bitches, you gotta make this happen, man. And seriously though, if they only make it like PS3 backwards compatibility, I'm gonna be happy, man, because we already know PS4 is gonna be a thing. So I'm gonna be selling my PS4 Pro a month before or some like that. But I also do want to get rid of my PS3, and I want to be playing games on PS5, so I'm really hoping this rumor is true. Let me know your thoughts on it, and if you're on the Xbox, hey, let me know in the comments below if you want to see something like that come to Xbox. I think Microsoft will compete. And on the other hand though, speaking of Modern Warfare, we actually got good news, and I'm kind of shocked. I mean, I haven't played Modern Warfare in the longest, and I'm kind of shocked that we're getting this news. I mean, it's coming from Joel Emsley. This is the man who actually flew me out, put me under the umbrella of Octavision, and I was like, okay, nah, I kind of pulled out. But the thing is that Ghost was like, we need more 6v6 maps, and Joel came out and said that, we completely hear you guys on this, been working on it, and continue as fast as we humanly can. And listen, man, Joel, I think he's only in for making the art and all of that like look as good as possible. And I gotta be real, Modern Warfare team and the art is actually fantastic, because not only that it separates from all the other games that we have seen on the market, it also separates from all the other Modern Warfare games. So the art is absolutely fantastic. I think Joel did a fantastic job, and he's not in for the communication, but the fact that he's communicating with the fans while like other Infinity Ward communication managers, I'm not trying to take shots at anybody, but all the other community managers are blocking people. They're telling the fans to go pound sand. They're dropping like Mickey Mouse's gifts, cat stickers, this and that. Joel Emsley, coming out of nowhere, RKOing nobody and communicating with the fans and saying that they are working on it. I mean, this is a shocker. I'm looking at it, I'm like, wow. I mean, pretty good news, because Modern Warfare has like a couple of problems. For example, skill-based matchmaking, footstep audio, minimap, you know, this is controversial. And it also needs more maps, right? Because the game only got like, what, 6 maps in terms of 6v6. And the maps aren't really fun to play. I would say Ground War is the best in this game, but let's say you don't like Ground War, or you love Ground War, the thing is that you only have like a limited amount of maps. So the game definitely has that content problem, and I'm glad to hear that we're gonna be getting more maps. And also in the news, I'm hearing that Activision made money. It says that Call of Duty titles generated over $1.1 billion in revenue in 2019, and man, I'm like, okay, well, shit, it's going down. Call of Duty is far from being dead, and I'm looking at all the comments. People are like, Call of Duty is dead, this and that. And listen, man, I'm a fan of Call of Duty, but it's getting to the point where it's like another year, another Call of Duty. So they're like, I'm getting that, right? But the fact of the matter is, it's making money. I mean, check this mofo out. Call of Duty Modern Warfare racked up $640 million in 2019, while Black Ops 4 racked up $487 million, and the rest of it is just like the other, the older Call of Duty games, right? And keep in mind, these are just like video game sales of Call of Duty alone, and this is not microtransactions, because I heard that during the dead period of time for Black Ops 4, they made about like $3 to $4 billion, and that was off of microtransactions only in one quarter, okay? So Activision is making moolah, and they are printing benches, guys. Like, they're not gonna cry in the Lambo, I can guarantee you that. But speaking of GTA 6, we have some, I would say, good news. First of all, I wanna bring this to your attention. Not sure if you guys have seen this or not, but if you have, this is fake, okay? So don't let your dogs out. I actually got new information, or I should say something that I already reported on, but I want to be combining all of that in one video. But the thing is that if you have seen this, this is fake. I'm not really gonna get into it, because my good friend, who I've never met before, I mean I know this guy on the internet, Zach TV, I don't wanna pronounce his YouTube username because I'll probably butcher it, but Zach actually made a full video on debunking the whole thing. He talks about why it's fake, this and that, and he has really good points, and obviously it's not sitting well with the homies. It was deleted as well over on the Reddit, so, you know, people are like, I have limited edition copy of GTA 7. My uncle works at Nintendo and he told me GTA 8 will be 100% released. But out of all this bullshit, we have some pretty credible news, and I mean, wow, I'm kind of shocked, because it's coming from Say Cheese TV. This account is definitely suspect. I know that a lot of people are saying this, but the thing is that they actually provided legal documents that they received, or someone else that they know received. And the documents were talking about the fact that Rockstar want to come in for a visit, they want to sip some marks, they want to be looking at the business interior for their upcoming game, which may or may not be GTA 6. They said they are looking, scouting the area, and we're assuming that it's GTA 6, right? Let's be real, it's GTA 6. I don't think it's gonna be Bully 2. It can be that medieval game that we heard about, but I think it's GTA 6. That's kind of like what I want to believe in, but they provided all the evidence, and they said that GTA 6 will not be ready in time for PS5 and new Xbox launch next year. And you know what? All the other leaks are saying that GTA 6 coming 2020, it's coming in May 2020, GTA 6 in your butthole, Fernando got the GTA 6. You know, everyone is talking that it's coming like now and now, but this leak, Say Cheese TV, says that it's not gonna be ready in time for PS5, and it sounds believable because it's separating for all the other leaks except for that Project America leak, which did say that it's gonna be coming out 2021 or 2022. So I personally believe that it's gonna be coming out then, and they also say that GTA 6 is rumored to take place in Miami, something we heard from other leaks as well, and Rockstar has been teasing it in GTA Online. So I absolutely believe it to be in Miami. It will feature hurricanes, gators, and the map will be 3 times bigger than GTA 5 and not 40 times bigger like the other leaks claimed, right? So it's gonna be 3 times bigger, and honestly I'm pretty excited for it. Like I just wanna like look at the graphics. I just wanna play the game on PS5 hoping that it's at least 60 FPS ready for 4K, and hopefully we can upscale it to 8K because PS5 will be able to do that. But I'm pretty certain that it's gonna cook itself and it's gonna send itself to console heaven. Hopefully not. Hopefully they test it out before shipping that one out. But I'm just excited for it. And on the other hand though, this information also broke this week. David Vonderhaar said that the next Call of Duty will not have jetpacks, and we know that Treyarch have already confirmed it after we heard the leaks that said that Black Ops or the next Call of Duty will either be Black Ops 5 or the Black Ops reboot will be set in Vietnam. So it makes sense for it to not have jetpacks, and by the looks of it, David Vonderhaar is back. And I know that a lot of people are questioning the fact that, yo, is he like really back? Like, didn't he had that mental breakdown a while ago where he was like, somebody who I admire told me to step away from Call of Duty. That is true though, but I think he didn't retire. I think he didn't like quit or anything like that. He just stepped aside and took a break, and by the looks of it, he's back working with Treyarch, and I'm hoping that he takes over like multiplayer, not only that, but campaign and zombies. Because David, I mean, Vonderhaar made Black Ops 2 and Blackout. He didn't work. I thought he worked on Black Ops 3, but apparently he did not. So you know what? Like, Black Ops 2 was a masterpiece, in my opinion. Blackout, given the amount of time he took to work on it, like, he didn't work on it for like years and years. He only worked on it for, let's say, a year and couple of months, right? And it was actually amazing. But let me know your thoughts below. Like and subscribe. Check out a video on the screen, and I will see you in the next one.